بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته All praise is due to Allah alone. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our souls and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead. And whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. I bear a witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah. And I bear a witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant and his last messenger. Dear viewers, welcome to the best of knowledge. The scholars have said that the best of knowledge is the knowledge that will enable you to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. And in this series, we'll be talking about the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mightiness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in each episode, we'll be talking about one of Allah's exalted attributes. And we will see how this attribute will impact our lives and how we should conduct ourselves in light of this attributes. And today we'll be talking, inshallah, about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named himself by the name of the most merciful and the most gracious and the most beneficent. Allah Ta'ala said, تَنزِيلٌ مِّنَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ This book is a revelation from the most merciful, the most gracious, Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So Allah Ta'ala named himself to be the most merciful and the most gracious. And he further named himself Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to be the best of those who show mercy. Allah Ta'ala is the best of those who show mercy. Allah Ta'ala said, فَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ حَافِظًا Allah Ta'ala is the best who show guarding, and the best who show mercy. وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ And he is the best of those who show mercy. Allah Subhanahu Allah's mercy has encompassed everything, has embraced everything. Allah's mercy Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, when Allah Ta'ala spoke about His mercy, said, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ And my mercy has encompassed everything. My mercy has embraced everything. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, if we want to talk about the example of His mercy. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in one occasion, he saw a woman, and that was in one of the battles called the Battle of Hunain. He saw a woman running and searching for her child. And once she found the child, she took hold of him and she started breastfeeding him before the companions. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said to them, do you think that this woman will throw her child to the hell, to the hellfire? They said, Ya Rasulullah, never. O Rasulullah, O the Nabi of Allah, she will never do so. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied saying, Allah the Almighty is more merciful towards His slaves than this woman towards her child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so merciful towards his slaves. And His mercy is apparent in everything. Allah ta'ala encompasses everything with His mercy. His mercy is apparent and is shown in His in sending the books. Allah Ta'ala, when He sent the books to us, when He revealed the Quran, when He revealed all of the books to us to give us guidance on earth, it is a sign of His mercy. A sign of His mercy. Allah Ta'ala said, تَنزِيلٌ مِّنَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ This is a revelation from whom? The most merciful. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. And the most gracious. And Allah Ta'ala also said, Ar-Rahman, the most gracious. عَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنِ He taught the Qur'an. It is out of mercy that Allah Ta'ala revealed the books. And also a sign of His mercy, or His mercy is also shown in sending the messengers. Allah Ta'ala sent the messengers out of mercy to us. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ O Muhammad, We have not sent you except as a mercy to all of humanity. Allah Ta'ala sent him as a mercy to us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala furthermore packaged his message with mercy, with leniency. Allah Ta'ala made him so merciful and so lenient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he spoke about his message, Allah Ta'ala said, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ O Muhammad, because of that mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you became lenient towards them. You became soft towards them. You became kind towards them. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضَّى If you were harsh, O Muhammad, غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ And hard-hearted, لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ They would have scattered away from you. So Allah Ta'ala packaged his sending and his message with mercy, with kindness. It is a sign of his mercy. Furthermore, a sign of Allah's mercy, or Allah's mercy is also shown in his legislation. In his legislations, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, when he spoke about the salah, the prayer, he said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُضِيعَ إِيمَانَكُمْ Allah Ta'ala was not his purpose to cause your good actions to be lost. إِنَّ اللَّهَ بِالنَّاسِ لَرَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمِ Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is full of pity, full of mercy towards people. And also his mercy, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is shown in the mercy that we have amongst ourselves. The mercy that we have amongst ourselves is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The mutual love that we have amongst ourselves is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The mutual kindness that we have amongst ourselves is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the sound hadith in the book of Al-Bukhari, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created mercy in 100 parts. And then he said, and Allah Ta'ala retained 99 parts of the mercy with him for the day of resurrection, to become merciful towards his slaves in the day of resurrection. So Allah Ta'ala retained 99 mercies with him for the day of resurrection. And Allah Ta'ala sent down only one mercy to earth. Allah Ta'ala sent down this mercy to earth, and with this mercy we are having mutual love amongst us. And we are having mutual kindness amongst us. It is a sign of Allah's mercy. And also, another sign of Allah's mercy is the provision that He has given to us. Although we are disobeying Him, we are sometimes, some of us are rejecting Him, some of us are denying His rights, and He's still providing us with provision, with sustenance, and it is a sign of His mercy. Allah Ta'ala, when He spoke about His provision, Allah Ta'ala said, رَبُّكُمْ Your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الَّذِي يُزْجِي لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ فِي الْبَحْرِ The one who drives the ships for you in the sea, out of mercy. لِتَبْتَغُوا مِن فَضْلِهِ So that you may gain from his provision. إِنَّهُ كَانَ بِكُمْ رَحِيمًا Allah Ta'ala is so merciful towards his slaves. It is a sign of His mercy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us all of these bounties. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala furthermore, although He is very merciful towards His creation, Allah ta'ala has a special mercy towards the believers. A very special mercy towards the believers. And Allah ta'ala, when He spoke about His highness and His loftiness, He mentioned His mercy. Just to give peace of mind to the believers, just to comfort the believers, Allah Ta'ala said, Ar-Rahman, the most gracious, ala al-arsh istawa, rose above the throne. And also when He spoke about His throne, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the sound hadith said that His mercy precedes His anger. Allah Ta'ala wrote in a book above His throne that His mercy precedes His anger. وَرَحْمَتِي كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ Your Lord has prescribed upon himself mercy. Allah Ta'ala prescribed upon himself mercy. And that's why the angels who are bearing the throne, they know that Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala is full of mercy. And Allah Ta'ala has encompassed everything with His mercy. And that's why they make the dua, the supplication to Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala to forgive the believers. Allah Ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ يَحْمِلُونَ الْعَرْشِ, those who carry the throne, وَمَنْ حَوْلَ, and those who are around them, يُسَبِّحُونَ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّهِمْ, they glorify Allah Subh'anaHu Wa Ta'ala. وَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ لِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ, and they seek forgiveness for the believers who are on the earth. And they say, رَبَّنَا وَسِعْتَ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ رَحْمَةً وَعِلْمًا, oh Allah, you have encompassed everything with your mercy. How we should conduct ourselves in light of this attribute? First of all, we must not be despaired from Allah's mercy. Those who despair from Allah's mercy, they are from those who are led astray. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَمَن يَقْنَطُ مِن رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ, and whoever despairs from Allah's mercy, وَمَن يَقْنَطُ مِن رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الضَّالُّونَ, except those who are from the misled people. So this is the first one. Secondly, we should ask Allah's mercy with determination, with firm asking. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, don't say, oh Allah, bestow your mercy if you wish, but say, oh Allah Ta'ala, bestow your mercy upon me. Oh Allah, bestow your forgiveness upon me. Oh Allah Ta'ala, encompass me with your mercy. So ask it with determination. Thirdly, do the actions that will enable you to gain Allah's mercy. One of them is to establish the prayer and to give his zakah. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ, and establish the prayer. وَآتُ الزَّكَاةِ, and give his zakah. وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ, and obey the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, so that you may gain Allah's mercy. And also, seek Allah's forgiveness, because that will enable you to gain Allah's mercy. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهِ, why don't you ask Allah's forgiveness? Why don't you seek Allah's forgiveness? لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, to have the mercy of Allah Ta'ala bestowed upon you. Also, finally, be merciful towards people, and this will make you liable for Allah's mercy. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا يَرْحَمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الرَّحَمَاءِ, indeed Allah bestows his mercy upon those who are merciful towards people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase our knowledge and to increase our iman, and I'll see you soon inshallah ta'ala in the next episode of the Best of Knowledge. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.